Welcome to a new Draw My Life video.
Imagine that you just got home, you turn on your computer, and you go to YouTube to watch a new Draw the Life video by TikTok. And all of a sudden, your body bursts into flames. If you haven't heard about a spontaneous human combustion before, you might be thinking that we are crazy. But this strange phenomenon has actually been taking place for a long time, and no scientific explanation of it has yet appeared. Weird, right? However, what exactly is a spontaneous combustion? Well, it is a phenomenon in which the body of a human being bursts into flames for no apparent reason. In general, when this happens, the victim ends up scorched up to the bones. But some of the limbs, generally the hands and feet, remain intact. Also, objects near the body that combusted barely show signs of burning. Over the years, several reports about instances of a spontaneous combustion have been collected, and thanks to that, it has been possible to determine that there is a series of factors which occur in every instance. It normally happens to people of old age who are overweight, smoke, suffer from alcoholism to some degree, and live alone. Let's review some of the most well-known cases. Some of them are very interesting. The first case dates back to 1664 and happened in Paris, France, when a Danish citizen described the way in which a woman burst into flames on the straw mattress she was sleeping on, while the mattress remained intact. In 1765, Cornelius Undari de Bandy, Countess of Cesena, also suffered from a spontaneous combustion. Her maiden found a countess' body in her room, turned into ashes, although the legs and head remained relatively intact. According to the maiden, the bed and other furniture of the countess was not affected by the fire, although it ended up covered in a greasy layer of soot. All that was found of John Irvin Bentley were his legs in Pennsylvania, USA, in December 1966. The fire was so intense that it opened a hole in the ground, but there were no signs of burning or other fires in the rest of the house. The most known case of spontaneous combustion is probably the case of Mary Reeser, a 67-year-old widow from St. Petersburg, Florida. She was found by her son on the morning of July 2, 1951. He said that the last time he saw her was the previous night, and that she was smoking and sitting on the chair where her corpse was found. All that was left of her body was ashes, bone fragments, teeth, and a foot inside her sneaker. The chair she was sitting on ended up scorched, and there were signs of burning on the floor and the ceiling. However, a pile of papers she had by her side remained intact. Thousands of theories circulated regarding the death of Mary Reeser. Suicide using gasoline, murder with a flamethrower, among many others. The FBI closed the case saying that the woman fell asleep while smoking, and that her clothes were set on fire because her cigarette fell on them. Dr. Wilton Crockman, specialist in deaths by fire, said that the Mary Reeser case was the most unsettling case he had ever participated in. He even said, "If we were living in the Middle Ages, I would say this is a result of dark magic." If you're interested in learning about more cases of spontaneous combustion, you can read about them in the book titled Spontaneous Human Combustion, where Jenny Randles and Peter Huff gathered around 111 instances of this phenomenon. The most widely accepted explanation regarding spontaneous human combustion is the wick effect theory. This is the name given to the partial destruction of the human body due to fire when the clothes of the victim get impregnated with his or her own body fat, thus acting as the wick of a candle. A clothed human body works like an inverse candle. The body fat works as fuel while the clothes work as a wick, so that if the body combusts, the body fat works as a continuous source of fuel. This is why the fire produced by a spontaneous combustion can last for several hours. Although the wick effect is the most rational theory, no conclusive evidence has appeared which demonstrates that this is the true reason why a spontaneous combustion occurs. Some people talk about divine interventions or even unknown subatomic particles which can ignite within human bodies. What do you believe is the cause of a spontaneous combustion?
If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like it. And if you want to see more Draw My Life videos, subscribe to our channel. See you in the next episode!